Hello everybody, it's Cape Rugby TV, Wednesday night, 9 o'clock, and we bring you the very best of what's happening in the world of club rugby. Western Province Club Rugby, that is. Big thanks to Hisense that has come on board with Cape Rugby TV as the official technical partner, and of course, Score Energy Drink. Score will be hosting the Sevens Tournament starting, I think, on the 1st of October, 1st or 8th of October. We'll talk more about that a little bit later. And of course, the President's Cup is coming up. They had the draw on Monday night. We'll talk about the President's Cup fixtures. That's, of course, the teams in Super League A, B, and C. We know at the moment the Promotions League is running. Those are from the top three in the City, Southern, and Northern Leagues. Anyway, we'll talk more about that a little bit later, as well as the highlights from the match, Hands and Hearts against Kraaifontein. It's a cracker of a match. Huge amount of points and tries scored. But let me introduce you to my panel this evening, Ishmael Dali Harish.
Yeah, Jape's been a while since I've been on the show. Good to be back.
Yeah, nice to have you here. I think we're all also very interested in talking about how Milnerton is doing. If there's any chance of you guys getting promoted this year, but we'll see how that goes.
Done deal, eh?
Done deal. I don't understand how you guys make these announcements all the time. Anyway, Jerome Paardwater is on the show with me, Jerome. You doing well?
Yeah, JP, thanks. Very well.
Lekker, lekker. All right. Of course, you've been busy with the under-21s, so we're going to have a little chat about the under-21s tonight as well. You satisfied with their performance?
Yeah, JP, but didn't go our way on Saturday, but yeah, at the moment I am.
Yeah, it's a start. It's a start to everything. Don't worry, Alistair Coetzee is also having a start. We'll talk about that start maybe a little bit later. Right, folks, it was a monster game over the weekend. It was a derby match. It was Kraaifontein against Hands and Hearts. Now, for those of you that don't know why this is a derby match, I'm sure that there are a lot more reasons to the fact that it's a derby match, but we do know if you're out of living outside of the Cape Town area, well, Kraaifontein and Hands and Hearts, they live very close to each other. The two clubs are not far away, so a lot of clubs will be players will be between those two clubs. They work in the same environment. So, of course, a little bit of news for those of you that have just joined us on Cape Rugby TV. So, derby match time. Derby match time is when we have thousands and thousands and thousands of fans around the field. Let's check out the first half highlights. Kraaifontein against Hands and Hearts. It's Kraaifontein, Hands and Hearts, 44 points and 40, I think that was the end result. But the halftime score there, 32-6, I think, 32-26. So lots of points on the board. Ish, when we look at a game like this, it's a big difference between looking at a game like this where you can see all these tries. It makes for entertaining rugby. It's really nice to watch the highlights package. we're seeing all these tries.
Definitely, and you can clearly see the two contrasting styles of play. I mean, Hans and Arts thrives on, you know, this ball in hand approach, stepping, using lots of skills. Whereas Kruijff tends to, you know, take it up through the middle, gaining yards with the big runners. And it's good to see, I mean, value for spectators. I mean, with a scoreline like that at halftime, I would like to see the end result.
Well, we're about to see the end result there. Jerome, your feeling?
Yeah, entertaining rugby, JP. See, Kruijffontein, two quick tries there in the beginning, but it looked like Engenhout catch up there. And yeah, some good tries and good running rugby.
Okay, so we're about to see the second half highlights now. What do you look for when you watch highlights package like this? You've only got 2.5 minutes. What's the kind of things that you're looking for?
Hey, you obviously look at, obviously the first thing is look at the fitness levels of the guys and skills levels, and just see in certain positions, specific what the guys are doing right and what the guys are doing wrong.
Ish, yourself?
Yeah, for my side, it's very easy to focus on try scorers, you know, but my eye tends to focus on the guys that are not closely to the ball, you know, so the guys that are working off the ball, what's their work rate like, what's their body language, their attitude. That gives an indication of, firstly, the teamwork ethic and as well as the individuals as well.
All right, well, let's take a look now. Now we know what to look for. Let's take a look at the second half highlights. Welcome back. There we go. Second half highlights. All right, Ish. More thoughts?
Very high scoring game. Attack is great from both sides. I cannot say that about the defense.
Yeah. Super League B, big one for Kruijffontein, the fact that they needed these points to avoid relegation.
Yeah. Kruijffontein is always tough playing at home, and with that being a derby, playing against their neighbors, I'm sure they were always going to pull out a big one, especially knowing that they needed to stay away from that promotion relegation playoff.
Jerome, Hands and Hearts playing typical Hands and Hearts rugby, but it's the fans, the Gies. I mean, you can see the spirit of the team always. I think Hands and Hearts is one of those teams that just, they really do go out there and show, I think they've kind of, people are knowing Hands and Hearts as the team with the Gies, or the fans with the Gies. I know there's a lot of fans like that, but... Nice,
yeah, definitely, JP, but I think it's a thing in Kruijffontein. You can go to any rugby game in Kruijffontein. Also, Kruijffontein, you see their spectators. You see the Hands and Hearts spectators, how they enjoy the game. So I know Kruijffontein also have that vibe. Hands and Hearts have that vibe. So I think in general, the people in Kruijffontein, they just love their rugby. And it's good to see that how they support their teams, no matter what.
Well, I can tell you no matter what. There wasn't a single person at Kruijffontein on Saturday who didn't say that he was a family member of Wade van Niekerk. I'm pretty sure. And Jason Colby as well. So, I'm okay for Wade, no. My neef, my nuchi, okay. Something like that. Now, that would be in... but yeah, we'll claim him. I understand his old Kraaifontein, Scottsville, Scottsdene area boy. So nice to know we've got talent out there, not only on the rugby field, but also now on the Olympic stage. Folks, as you can see behind me, score is on the TV screens in the back, on the high-end screens. And has, of course, come on board with Western Province Rugby in terms of the Sevens tournament that's coming. From what I understand now, there are, well above the number of teams that are going to be playing. There's been applications, plenty of applications. I think that this is absolutely fantastic. Ish, if we just think back, and I'm going to talk about score in a second, folks, because you can win yourself a case of score. If we just think back now to the end of last year, we started the Sevens tournament. It actually started as the Cape Rugby TV Sevens tournament together with Western Province just to get the ball rolling. And there was 24 teams, and it was a bit of a struggle with 24, which dropped down to 23, which dropped down to 20, and by the time we were finished, it was 20 teams, and everybody still played. They still played for that 6 or 7 week period. Now we've got a Sevens tournament that is running, and everybody wants to play. Oversubscribed. I mean, well, I don't know what do you think?
I think it's significantly grown over the last year, just in terms of its popularity and what it brings to the clubs. You know, I mean, it's more rugby, and just Sevens, it's entertainment. It's jam packed. It's based on entertaining the crowds and giving the crowds, you know, something to shout about. And it's just getting our guys back onto the field again. We're just extending that season again an extra couple of weeks.
Yeah, you can make up for that break.
Especially during mid-year, you know.
Excuse me, my throat has gone a little bit. Folks, you're right. If you want to win yourself a case of Score Energy Drinks, you can see Score's, of course, sponsoring a couple of the clubs out there as well. If you want to win yourself a case of Score Energy Drinks, then all you need to do is SMS the word SCORE to 33280, 33280, and you can win yourself a case of Score Energy Drinks. Congratulations to last week's winner, who walks away with a case of Score, Mike Pearlson. One of the guys from Cape Rugby TV, will be in touch with you soon. Right, of course, as was Hands and Hearts and Kraaifontein over the weekend. And as you know, we give away the Evox Advanced Nutrition Hamper, and we normally catch up with the captains and coaches. We'll do that after the break. Stick around. Welcome back, folks. Cape Rugby TV it is. Yes, look out for the Score Sevens tournament. That's coming up a little bit later, starting in October. It's going to be great fun. It's happening at Goodwood Rugby Club. There is going to be a kids' safe zone, jumping castles, MC playing music. There's a beer garden. That's going to be obviously creating a lot of opportunity for everybody. And there's going to be a lot of fun stuff as well, like Poiki Course competition. There's going to be a spirit squad with dancing girls and boys, keeping the crowd happy. So when Ish talks about entertainment at Sevens, it's happening right there in Cape Town at the Goodwood Rugby Football Club, which is nice and central for everybody. Lots of space, lots of parking. So that's where the Jewel is going to be happening starting October, the Score Sevens tournament. Right, we managed to catch up with the captain and coach of Hands and Hearts and, of course, Kraaifontein. We first speak to the Hands and Hearts captain, Alistair Frazenberg.
Goeie wen. Eerstens wil ek dankie sê aan die spectators. Mense wat agter ons staan het heel jaar. Amptelik klaar met die league games, maar is nog games oor. Ja, ek dink ons verdien die wen. Ons het ook Kraaifontein toe om 5 punte te kom haal. Ons het 5 gekry. Ek dink die hongerte was daar. Die hongerte was aan Kraaifontein se kant die selle. Maar ek dink op die einde van die dag het die ons karakter het ons deurgedra. Ek dink ons het games wat ons kon gewen het laat glip. Op time het ons fouten gemaakt waar die opponenten laat winnen. En ik denk dat we daar vanaf af geleerd. We zijn opgestaan en we de laatste 3-2 games het ons kon winnen. Ik denk die geest in die club zal een beetje optellen als we in de top 6 komen. Ik denk dat ons als die kampioenen van die presidentskap zo een goede geleentheid om het weer te gaan vinden.
Right, Alistair Frazenberg has been leading from the front for quite a while there. Nice to see Alistair always so positive about things. And big boy, Jerome's Alistair, he's been leading from the front there for quite a while. Rock solid leadership. Reminds me a little bit of JB van Staal at Tigerberg.
Yeah.
Captain from the front for many years.
Yeah, definitely. And he's always at training sessions. I've done a few training sessions at the Hands and Hearts. He's always there. He's been part of our club squad earlier in this year. And yeah, he's leading from the front, and he's a respectable guy also in Kraaifontein, and the guys are looking up to him, so it's good to have a leader like that. And I also see now what he's talking about, that the next challenge for them is they're the winners of the President's Cup, so they've got something to play for, so I think they're going to make it difficult for teams playing against him.
Yeah, and of course, I think it might have been last year at the President's Cup that the Hands and Hearts fans actually won the fan award. So here we go, like I said, the Hands and Hearts fans are, they're making even, they won some money with it. I think it was a 5,000 rand bonus or something to that effect. We'll talk about the President's Cup a little bit later, folks. As I said, the draw was done on Monday. We'll now know out of the Super League A, B and C who is playing the President's Cup, and we'll also talk about the fixtures in terms of the first round of qualifiers. Peter Links is, of course, the coach at Hands and Hearts. He's been there for a while, also doing a good job as a coach. Let's catch up with Peter now.
Yeah, kijk, a derby is not always makkelijk nie. The game kon enige kant toe gegaan het. Kraaifontein het gekom om te wen. En dan Kraaifontein 5 punte gesoek onself, omdat die posisie waar ons nou lê was 5 punte nodig gewees. Maar daarbij al altijd die beste uit jou het, en ons vandaag kon ons gesien het rugby het geseef hier. Albei spanne het klomp 3 gedring, ek dink ons het 6 en hulle het ook 6-3 gedruk, so dit getuig van goeie kwaliteit rugby. Kijk, Hensenaars het oor die jare het hulle toeskouwers wat ooral waar hulle gaan, is hulle altyd die meeste. En dit betekent baie vir die span, alhoewel ons is thuis dorp, so dat was nog nie baie moeite om ver te rij nie, maar dit is altyd ooral al spelers waar. Ons het altyd die meeste mense, so in dit draad, dit doen baie goed vir die span. Die geest waar hy was, tel die ouwens op. Ek meen, ons kon sien vandag, die wedstrijd was 50-50, dan loop hulle voor, dan loop ons voor, en ek hoor jy die geskree van achter, dit het jy ons opgetel, dit het jy ons deurgedra, en dit is lot waardeer. Ja, kyk, wat ons definitief weet, is dat ons dinsdag aan terug is op die veld, om te voor te bereid, vir eerskomende saterdag se wedstrijd. Ons weet nie waar ons aan eindig nie. Ons het nog geen uitslag gekry nie, of het nou 60 gaan wees, of 7e of 8e, ons moet net opdag en het daarvan af verder beplan vir die presidentskap, of ons nou onder gaan speel, of boot, maak nie saak nie, maar die boys weet, ons dinsdag gaan trek ons weer saam, en dan kom ons met die voorbereiding.
Peter Links, of course, coach at Hands and Hearts. So we managed to catch up with Kraaifontein captain Zander Case.
Ek weet, al die eer aan die Here gewees vir hierdie voorreg. Was 'n harde derby, Kraaifontein, Hands and Hearts, altyd 'n derby. Hulle het weggekom met die punte, maar ons kyk maar vir ander uitslae en kyk, miskien bly ons in hierdie gang. So, ons het 'n goeie build-up gehad, goeie wen laas naweek gehad, weg te Makassa, maar soos ek sê, Hands and Hearts met hulle fans altyd lekker. Verseker, ons het goed begin hierdie jaar. Geslip hier in die middel van die seisoen, weer opgetel, weer geslip, maar ons kyk vir volgende jaar, miskien bly ons.
And then Manny De Paver is of course the coach at Kraaifontein. We managed to speak to Manny after the game.
Baie hard, ja, was moeilik. Was a tie game. Ek wil net eerstens vir Hands and Hearts sê, baie dankie vir 'n lekker game. Was regtig 'n goeie game rugby. En dis waarvoor ons hier is om lekker rugby te speel. Jong, het was my hard. Ons het 'n baie taai seisoen op en af, rollercoaster. Maar die manne het hard gewerk, hulle het geweet ons moet wen. Ons wil survive het in die liga. Ek dink ons maak het, iemand het ons gehelp langs die pad. Maar ons wil graag die wen gehad het vandag, regtig, het was vir ons belangrik. Man, ons gaan nou probeer om die manne te hou, die bottom uit gaan speel. Dit hopelik wen en dan maar werk na volgende jaar toe. En 'n beter seisoen hê as die jaar.
Manny De Paver is the coach at Kraaifontein-ish. He will be a little bit disappointed, but I'll be looking to have a better season next year.
Yeah, I think it's something that he can build on, but I think they've still got the bottom eight to play, and that's over the next 2 weeks, and so the season's not done. As you said, hopefully they can maintain and keep the players that they currently have and build on that.
Yeah, Jerome?
Yeah, as you say, it's going to be challenging now for him to keep the players positive, but they still have these games to play. So hopefully the guys pitch and go train, because it's a new week again.
Well, isn't that the challenge that most of the coaches have got? Everybody is sort of now, as we said, call it the business end is almost done. Can you lift the players to play in the Promotions League, the Bottom Eight, the President's Cup?
For me, statistically, over the past couple of years, when the President's Cup was introduced and this promotion relegation, the bottom team always tends to lift their game up when they're playing a team in the top league, in the league above them, for the promotion relegation playoff. And purely on motivation, I think, and obviously they've been winning more games than the team in the top league. And so by mere stats, I think it's going to be difficult for those top teams to bring their guys with some energy and motivation just to maintain it. But it's important for the coaches just to give it that one last push, especially if the club still want to stay in that specific league.
Yeah. All right, Evox Advanced Nutrition, as you see behind me, is of course the official sports nutrition supplier to Western Province Rugby and the DHL Stormers. And on a weekly basis, we give a Man of the Match prize to the whoever the star player is. And it's selected, of course, by the coach of the winning team. In this case, it was Hands and Hearts, and Peter Links and the boys managed to choose the Evox Man of the Match, and it was none other than Brandon Collins.
It was a hard game. Everyone was looking forward to the game. We knew it was going to be hard, but at the end, it was just the best team we had to win. They played a big role into this game for me. They said before the game they're just going to play on my side. When they played on my side, I've done the best of it and I've just finished it off. I'm very proud of myself, and that's it, yes.
All right, Brandon Collins, congratulations. You walk away with that Evox hamper, and sure, you'll be packing on the muscle. Remember, if you're a club rugby player, you qualify for sponsorship rates, and you're able to go directly to the Evox factory, so to speak, or the warehouse in Northgate. Just get a hold of, go onto the club rugby website, and you'll see the banner on the right-hand side, and apply there, and someone from Evox will get in touch with you, so that you can get your Evox products via West Brom's Rugby at a special price. All right, folks, we're going to take an ad break. When we come back from the ad break, we'll take a look at the fixtures in Super League, at least some of the other results in Super League A, B, and C. Back in a sec. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, it's Cape Rugby TV. Remember, if you've got your photographs and stories to share, then please go to our Facebook page, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV, and share your pictures and stories, and hopefully we'll get it up on the show. Let's take a look at the results now in Super League A. And it was UWC that went down to SK Wilmers over the weekend, 50 points to 5. For Durbel, 68-36 over Kales River. Vicks, 26-25 over NNK. Just a 1-point win there. And then Stellenbosch with a massive win, 61-0 over Primrose. And then Hamilton's beat UCT, 39 points to 19. All right, let's quickly talk about some of those results. If you're sort of in the middle of the league at the moment, you're not really bothered. If you know, even at the top of the league, maybe you're not really bothered anymore because the league winners have been announced already, which we'll maybe discuss that a little bit further. But SK Wilmers beating UWC Jerome, I would have expected a smaller gap between UWs and SK Wilmers.
Yeah, definitely, because obviously if I was the guys at UWC, they sort of finished the varsity shield on a high, but where they are now, it's a bit disappointing to see. And I mean, they should have used this now to prepare for next year's varsity shield, because I think they can do much better. But so I don't know what happened there.
Well, I
but
saw it's up to SK. Kelsover. I mean, and UWC has actually got a good side. There's not a 45 point difference, in my opinion, between SK and.
I beg to differ. I think SK can beat any team on any given day. I think they were the only team to run Falls Bay, the league winners, close. I think Falls Bay beat them 11-10. The only other team to draw with them was Hamilton's. Yeah. So SK can pitch up on any given day, and they can decide, listen, yeah, let's give this team 50, or they can lose to Brackenfell or whoever.
It's a hot and cold thing. Sometimes teams are up, sometimes teams are down.
It is what it is, and you got to make sure you're pitching up every single weekend.
The team that looks to me like they pitched up this weekend, even though they lost, was Kales River, 36-68 against Durbel, after the loss against Marty's, which I believe was something like in the hundreds, and maybe 7 points on the board for them. So massive loss against Marty's. but then putting 36 points on the board against Durban. So, Jerome, I mean, maybe Kells River's on the up?
Yeah, I mean, they lost that game, but it's a sort of a good better result than Marty's.
Yeah.
And it's also, I mean, they had a disappointing season. And a club like Kells River, you know, good, all the spectators, and they've got a good thing going there, good vibe. So it's also disappointing to see where they are, and I think they in a bit of trouble now.
Yeah, well, we haven't quite got to the relegation stuff yet. NNK, with a 1-point loss against Vicks, they're really showing their stuff.
Yeah, I think it was, I think Wilbur Krak is the coach at NNK, and he's done exceptionally well with that team. And they were desperate for any points last weekend, and they've gotten that point.
But was he actually with the team on the weekend?
In spirit, yes.
In spirit, he would have been with the emerging team as well. Yeah.
Definitely, but he definitely gave them some tips throughout the week.
I can
guarantee you that.
Over the phone.
Yeah.
Run the ball wide.
No, I just think Super A is very much split into two different leagues. I mean, you've got your top six.
Yeah.
Which is completely like semi-professional, and then you've got your bottom eight who's just like fighting it out every week to get any points just to stay in the league.
Yeah.
So there's a massive gap in that Super A league.
And then Primrose, they went down to Stellenbosch 61-0. Hammy's beating UCT 39-19.
UCT's been a bit disappointing the whole year, I think, starting from the Varsity Cup already, and I thought maybe they'll pick it up coming into the league. Unfortunately, it didn't happen for them. So, I mean, they've got to re-look at and re-strategize going into next year's Varsity Cup with new coaches, new players and player recruitment they've got to look at. So, it will be interesting to see where they kick off their campaign next year.
Hammies still haven't given up the ghost, even though they haven't won the league. They're still pumping it out, beating UCT. All right, let's take a look at the results in Super League B. Collegians went down to Peniel Villages over the weekend, 24-15. A massive win for Union Mill over Macassar, 71-0. Belleville beating Villages, 38 points to 20. And then Helderberg, 57-7 over Goodwood. Strand went down to Young Peoples, 57-21. Crumpton, Hands and Hearts, that was our feature game, with a win for Hands and Hearts. And then Violets went down to St. George's over the weekend, 37 points to 25. A good win for Peniel Villages at Collegians. That's home ground advantage for Collegians. You can see why they're going to get promoted.
Definitely. And it's not very easy to play Collegians at Collegians, especially the type of rugby they're playing. And at the moment, I mean, Union Milton played Collegians last weekend, and Union Milton beat them by 1 point. And it really, really shows you that there's lots and lots of talent in Mitchell's Plain. It's important for that talent to be nurtured, to be given an opportunity.
Yeah.
And I'm sure they can reach the sky with the amount of talent they have there.
Talking about Union Mill, I see you guys on Ish, you guys put up a big poster on the weekend, Super League B winners. Have you not learned from anybody that putting up the poster?
That must have been one of the spectators that has done that. I'm not too sure.
I don't know, JP. We must have a look at the... It's all the coaches who's with the emerging team that do this kind of thing. So I don't know what's happening.
I remember a few years ago watching Boerland play against Western Province. Robbie Fleck was running towards the try line, and he was just about to score, and Dion Kayser tackled him from behind. Robbie Fleck thought he had the ball down and he was going to score. And he got tackled from behind and the ball went over and he didn't score the try.
That's this year. Next year's a different year. So then we'll speak a different ball game.
Are you sure you've won the league? how do you actually know you've won the league? Until you get given the... I mean, how do you know you've passed matric until you get a certificate?
Based on your mock results and...
All right, Jerome. Belleville beat Villages over the weekend, 38 points to 20. Villages have been playing some 50-50 rugby, but not bad. I mean, that's a good result for Belleville.
Yeah, it's a good result because Villages, as you say, they also made a step up. So that's a great result. And Belleville, I mean, they've done well.
Belleville beat Union Mill. Belleville beat this year. In fact, we were at the game this year. Belleville beat Milton on home ground.
Yeah. And they have a very, very young side. So if they can keep that guys together, then who knows next year what they can do.
Yeah. And then, of course, I suppose wouldn't say it's a feature match, but St. George's with a good win over Violets would have also been a tough game. Mm. All right, folks, let's quickly look at Super League C. Hamad Diaz with a 37-25 win over Blue Jets. It was a win for Langa, but Kyle Moore, Masi Pumalele went down to Franschhoek United. Young Stars, well, I'm not sure if that's a game or not, because of the 20 points nil normally means that that one of those, that game could have been forfeit or something happened there. Wraithby beat Scottsdene, and Rangers beat Paul, and then of course Lagunya went down to Strand United. Masi Pumalele is not the same team that they were 3 years ago under the leadership of Warren Edwards, where they won every single game in a row. They're going to want to look to turn it around in 2017.
They must, definitely, JP. I was there earlier this year also. I must say they had a lot of numbers at the training field, but they also, where they were, the guys who are in charge of the club must get back to where they were and just put the work in, because they've got a good thing going there. So it's sad to see where they are at the moment.
Yeah, okay, let's look at the results in the Promotions League. And then we'll also take a look at some of the logs. Stelcor 38-22 over Silvertree. It was a win for Vineyards over Busy Bees. And then All Saints with a win over Eps33, 31 points to 7. In the second round competition results, the City League first, Tempins and Cities went down to Police. It was a win for Progress, 15-0 over Watsonia. In the Northern League, Van der Stel with a 52-32 win over Atlantis. Noordlikers went down to Bishop Lavers. And in the staying in the Southern League, it was a one-point win for Peninsula over Rocklands. But folks, we're going to take an ad break. And when we come back, we'll take a look at some of the logs. And we'll also take a look at some of your social media photographs that came in during the course of the week. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, of course, it is Cape Rugby TV, and don't forget to tell your friends the best of what's happening in the world of amateur sport. Amateur rugby is right here on Cape Rugby TV. Don't forget, Factory Shops SA mobile app is, of course, a sponsor to Cape Rugby TV. Now, what you want to do is, if you need discounts, prices from any sort of retail shop or discount shop, you need to download the app. So grab your phone and go to either the Google Store or the iTunes Store and download the Factory Shops SA mobile app. And in there, just do a search for whatever product it is that you want, whether it's a brand or it's some clothing. You do a search and it'll bring up the shop that's nearest to you in that category. And then it's got GPS tracking that'll guide you to the shop. So you just push the button and off goes Google Maps, and turn left, turn right, takes you directly to the shop. Fantastic little app, Factory Shops SA mobile app. And of course, if you're a shop out there, you should get yourself listed. So grab the app, download it onto from iTunes or the Google Play Store, and get your shop listed on the app. Right now, Best Med has come on board as a sponsor to the Western Brabants Rugby School of Excellence. And this week we catch up with Johnny Kotze, who tells us, Chad Solomons, who tells us a little bit more about the life and times of a young man who came through the ranks and was, of course, included in the Best Med School of Excellence and is now a Currie Cup player.
The following Western Province Rugby School of Excellence insert is brought to you by Best Med. Be active, be safe, be happy, be NutriWise, be fin fit.
At the School of Excellence, I started at the age of 15 and then ended at the age of 18. So I spent quite a amount of time there with the School of Excellence. Which my last was being at the under 18. Mm-hmm. You would go for trials, or they send you for trials, like a first round, maybe like just in your area, which is like Curls River, where I'm from. And they'll go from there. You'll play there, like all the schools in the local area, and you go from there. Three guys, like, we went through the final trials at my school. So we knew it was going to come out on a specific day, and we came to school and like we couldn't focus and stuff. But then they called an announcement like at the school, and they said like our three names, and they actually announced it on the school announcements and said congratulations to Chad Solomon, etc., for making the under 13 camp. If you make it there, like you put your foot into the system, as they call it, and then from there I got a bursary to go to Port Rose Gymnasium, to obviously like a top rugby school, and then my next stage was in under 16, the Grand Como, which I captained that side. My first visit was probably at under 15, where I got selected in the, or before the under 16 Grand Como. they would select a big squad of like, I think 50 guys where you would go and train at the HBC, and like you come there and like you see all the like the big names. Like at the time, probably like John de Villiers, Schalk Berger, and those guys. You come there and like your eyes are just as big, like walking around there looking. When I got to the School of Excellence, like, it was a whole new world for me. Like getting there, like normally I'm used to just having one coach or two coaches, like a forward coach and backline coach. But getting there, we get physios, there's doctors, there's conditioning coaches for the gym. There's guys on the field working on your fitness, then your skills coach. You get kicking coach, obviously not me, but like you get your kicking coaches, you get also your normal forward coaches working on your position specifics. Like for me as a hooker, there will be someone helping me with my throwing. My best advice for any school kid out there, I would say is never give up firstly. Like if things don't go your way at the beginning, don't give up. Like your chance will come. Like there are so many opportunities out there. So never give up.
The following Western Province Rugby School of Excellence insert is brought to you by BestMed. Be active, be safe, be happy, be NutriWise, be fin fit.
Chad Solomon's talking to us there about his movement up through the ranks, and he really has come up right through the ranks from under 13 and all the way through to the Cravenweek side. Jerome, good player.
Yeah, very, very good player. I've known Chad from under 13. Under 16, with the under 18s, I've been involved with him. True professional, and he's still young, so I think we're going to see a lot of big things for him in the future. He's very positive, and as humble. I said, he's a true professional, and also the son of Chippy Solomons, who's the manager of the Stormers. But he's got a bright future ahead of him.
Very humble guy.
Mm. Very, very humble. And I think when you come out of Chippy Solomon's hands, you're going to be very humble. He will make sure that you are brought up in the right correct manner. So he's brought up in a rugby family, and I think it's in his genes. Chippy has been a rugby man from school days when he was a teacher already. So he's in the right environment, and he'll get the right guidance from his father. He's just got to make sure that he's focused and determined to make it work.
Yeah. All right, Chad Solomon's, of course, the player profile came through the ranks and has gone through the BestMed School of Excellence structure. All right, folks, as we said earlier on, we ask you to share your photographs of what you were up to, and we get some great action pictures. Lots of folks out there now, out there with a long lens, in some cases maybe not the longest of lenses, but still getting some really, really good pictures. Let's look at some of the photographs that we grabbed in over the weekend. First one was from Emil Krotz. That was in the match Masi Pumalele against Franschhoek United. One of the players diving for a ball there. And it was, of course, a win for Franschhoek United. And then Sukaina Basir shared the Hamilton's picture, where Hamilton's beat UCT 39-19. Front and center there, Anton Moorman. And you can see a couple of the guys in the picture there. Of course, Morgan Newman. Easy to spot, not a massive afro. Of course, Terry on the right-hand side there. Terry Jacobs plays wing. So all the Hammies boys. Another picture that came in also from Eddie Teron this week was the Union Mill win over Macassar 71-0, where they are bragging with what looks almost banner. Like a check, a Super League B banner. League banner. Winners 2016. It's not an official banner though, because there's obviously no Cape Rugby TV logo on that banner.
How do you now? Do you go to a game with the thing in your back pocket or the banner like that? Or because you still need to go play the game. How do you go and how do you make a banner like that?
Maybe guide us through this. Do you? It's like the speech, the Oscars. You write your winning speech before you get the Oscar award, and then you pull it out in case. So did you guys know beforehand that you were going to win the league?
Like I said, it was a spectator. It wasn't any of our coaches or management. It was.
So you guys didn't print the banner. One of your fans did.
Absolutely. That's the confidence the fans have in the club.
All right. Okay. Wow, that's incredible. When the fans are printing banners for you, clearly you guys have got no problem with sponsorship going into 2017. All right, then we'll talk more about that, the challenges of going up to Super League in a minute. Sali van der Voort also sent us a nice picture from their match Rangers against Paul, 38-31. Very happy couple of boys there, Rangers. You can see Ebi Murat there on the left-hand side. Kasim and a couple of the guys from Rangers in shot. And then, of course, from SK Warmers, UWC's... well, they of course went down to SK Warmers, but nice picture of the boys there after the game, SK Warmers against UWC. All right, folks, let's take a look now at some of the logs, and we'll take a look at the top six, of course, who are playing in the President's Cup, and we'll also take a look at the relegation space. First, of course, in the top six going into the President's Cup is False Bay, Stellenbosch, Durbel, Hamilton's, Tigerberg, and Vicks. They'll be playing it off in the President's Cup, but look at the bottom, Primrose, Kells River, and Solarians. So Solarians and Kells River definitely going to be relegated, and Primrose are going to go into a playoff. In Super League B, our top six there is going to be Union, World, Peniel, Villagers, Hamlets, Belleville, Villagers, and St. George's playing in the President's Cup. Bottom, going down into Super League C, will be Stranraer and Goodwood, and then there'll be a playoff for Macassar. In Super League C, we see Rangers, Paul, Franschhoek United, Langa, Kalamoor, and Young Stars all going to play in the President's Cup. While at the bottom, it's going to be relegation for Masipumulele, Silverleaf, and of course Blue Jets. And three will be coming up from the Super League. There won't be any playoffs in the Super League C, as far as I understand. So three at least clubs going up for sure, and three clubs going down. In the Promotions League, let's quickly look at the Promotions League log. Vineyards are at the top of the log with Stelco, All Saints, Manenberg, Rangers making up the top four. And then, of course, it's Busy Bees, Eersterivier, Silvertree, Young, Wesley's, and Retreat. In the City League, the log at the moment, Police, Tech, and Progress are at the top three. While we're in the Northern League, we see Whistling Wheels, Van der Stel, and Blake's taking up the space in the Northern League. In the Southern League, we see Bishop Lavis, Rocklands, Peninsula, and Young Brothers. All right, let's quickly take a look now at the President's Cup fixtures. This starts, of course, on the 3rd of September. So Super League A is going to be Durbel up against Vicks, Hamilton's, and Tigerberg. These are all on the 3rd of September. So home ground advantage then for Durbel in the first game. Hamlets take on St. George's in the Super League B roundup. Home ground advantage then for Hamlets. And then Super League C is Franschhoek United and Young Stars and Langa are up against Kylemore. In the semi-finals, well, of course, those were the qualifiers. And of course, then we move into the semi-finals. But that's going to be worked out only after the first round. So Durbel and Vicks, Hamilton's and Tigerberg, Hamlets and Georges, Belleville and Villagers, Franschhoek United, Young Stars, Langa, Kylemore. Right, folks, let's just have a look now also at the dynamics of the President's Cup. You've played in the President's Cup before. In fact, I think you guys have won it and you walked away with the prize money there. How important is it for the guys, the President's Cup? Have they got the gears for it yet? Is the President's Cup the game that you want to go to after the fact that you might have won or lost the league structures?
I can just speak from personal experience, and for us, the biggest motivation is playing at Newlands. And as a club player, you might never ever get the chance to play at Newlands. And this is your once in a lifetime opportunity to make it happen. And I still have fond memories of the last time we played there, whether it was winning or losing. You remember every single moment because it's a sacred ground.
Is it entertaining rugby? Is it something for the fans?
Absolutely. And I mean, there's prize money up for grabs. The gears and the vibe is great. You've got your fan awards. So Western Province have really done a great job in terms of creating that vibe around the President's Cup. Mm. It's all about the clubs now taking part, that wanting to get into that final and playing at Newlands.
All right, let's take a look now at the President's Cup bottom eight, starting also on the 3rd of September. SK Women's are up against Primrose, Brackenfell take on NNK, Belhar and UWC. Let's just talk about the President's Cup here. SK Primrose, they played against each other before already-ish. Mm. It's hard to lift yourself at this time of the year. You've dropped out, or you're at the bottom of the league. You're going to be playing in the bottom eight. You're not playing at Newlands. But a match like this, SK and Primrose, it's still going to be a bit of a derby match.
I think these two teams always deliver a cracker, especially being from the sort of same community. Yeah. And I don't think it will be any short of any fireworks and entertainment.
So Belhar and UWC?
Another cracker.
It's the same, right? Neighbours.
Neighbours.
So it's the same.
Again, we're going to see two big games here. Yeah. I mean, Even if, it doesn't matter where you're on the log, or we're looking at NNCAP Brackenfell, again, neighbours. Three neighbour games in Super League A. SK and Primrose, derby match. Brackenfell, NNK, just down the road from each other. And Belhaven, UWC, across the road from each other.
I think it's a bit of, there can be a bit of pride in that game. Like if, I think UWC lost against Belhaven, so they can make up.
Yeah. Kickoff, by the way, folks, kickoff on Saturday is 3:30. Remember now, because of that's probably because of the Curry Cup game, which kicks off at 5 o'clock. So, slightly later kickoff. Let's look at now Super League B in the bottom eight. Helderberg and Goodwood, Hands and Hearts, Macassar, Collegians, Kraaifontein, and then Violets are up against Young Peoples. In the Super League C bottom eight, it's Raithby and Masi Pumlele, Scottsdene and Blue Jets, Stand United against Langa, Elsie's take on Hamadiers. While in the Promotions League, we've got Vineyards up against All Saints. Busy Bees and Young Wesley, Silver Tree up against Retreat, and Manenberg Rangers are up against Esterafir. Kickoff there apparently at 4 o'clock on Saturday. So those games are still kicking off at 4 o'clock in the Promotions League. And then in the City League fixtures, it's Young Ideas against Western Zebras, Watsonian Police, Perseverance, Temperance, Caledonian Roses against Progress. In the Northern League on the second round fixtures there, as Van der Stel and Blakes, there's a derby for you. Blue Stars United against Delft, Kyliche and Atlantis, Strand Pioneers and Emikawi. While in the Southern League, we see Young Brothers up against Titans, Thistle and Noordlikers, Rocklands and Bishop Lavers. All right, gentlemen, Alistair, Kutsia, Jerome, just quickly, he's having a bit of a tough time. The Springboks are not playing the kind of rugby that should be world number one rugby.
Yeah, definitely, JP, but hopefully they can go and
turn it around.
Australia is a bit on a down, so hopefully they can get points there.
Is that what they need, Ish? They need a win under the belt?
Yeah, when you're playing at that level, winning is the most important thing. But I think with Springbok Rugby, our public and media is very much scrutinizing on performance. And unfortunately, the Springboks are not performing to the optimum.
Yeah. Folks, just incidentally, if you are out there and you're watching any club rugby game, please make sure that you respect the referee. Look after the referees. Remember, our referees are also just making as much of an effort in the amateur space as any amateur club rugby. So our referees are amateur as well. They come from a home with a family and the kids. Look after the referees at any club game and maybe take them to the after-match function and let them enjoy the hospitality there. If you're a fan, say thanks to the referee every now and then for refereeing the game. Very important that we look after our administrators and make the extra effort to keep our sport going. Right, gentlemen, Ish, for you, plans over the weekend?
I think to give our guys a break and watch some club rugby. Guys that are maybe taking each other on in the various other leagues. Thereafter, we'll prepare for the President's Cup.
Mm. Jerome, just quickly, the emerging side, they've had some good results.
Yeah, good results. They've done well. So now they through to the sort of the SA
semi-finals.
So hopefully, which I think with the team that they have, they can do it this year, bring back that cup.
Nice to see those young club rugby guys playing in that team. All the guys that have come through your hands, Isha's hands, Cape Rugby's hands.
Yeah, like I say, we always say this, JP, we're blessed with all the talent, and it's just now really guys need to come through, and just how we make it happen for guys to keep guys here and let him come through now. I don't know why Issa's laughing.
Right, that's a wrap then, folks. Remember now the Score Sevens tournament starting at Goodwood on the 8th of October. Lots of entertainment. There's going to be music, DJs, festivals. There's a beer garden. There is, of course, the kids' safe zone with jumping castles and minders. There's going to be dancing and entertainment from the Spirit Squad with boys and girls running around, making sure that everybody's having a great time. There's going to be poiky course competitions and briar flays. And really, it's just going to be Sevens at its best out of Western Province Club Rugby. And I understand that the competition is almost oversubscribed. There's how many clubs want to play in the Sevens competition. Starts off at Goodwood for 6 weeks running on the 8th of October. We'll keep telling you guys over the next couple of weeks about that competition. That's a wrap from us. We hope you have a good weekend. Ish, thanks for joining us.
Absolutely good to be back on the show.
Jerome?
Yeah, thank you, JP.
Right, folks, that's a wrap. Have yourself a fantastic rugby weekend. We'll see you on the park. Bye-bye.